Hi guys, today I'm bribing my family with Sunday lunch to help us down at the plot. So we're hoping to get the compost behind me just cleared out and taken to the dump. It looks like it could rain, so we need to get as much done as we can this morning before they get to eat the Sunday lunch.
I got poo!
Well, we got some compost. Well, it's just pure horse poo, isn't it? From Mum's house. Having some trouble with the raspberries, they've gone a bit yellow. So the weekend turned into a fairly large disaster. We managed to take one trailer full of the rubbish that's in the compost area to the dump, and my mum twisted awkwardly on her ankle and broke it. So she's in a cast now, which is just awful. And since then it's been raining, so things have been very slow this week at the allotment. One of the things Mum did bring was one bag of well-rotted horse manure. And we dug out a bit of a spot for the artichokes and put some of that manure in there. She also bought some chicken manure. These are in the pellets, and I'm going to put those onto those yellowing raspberries. Well, a few of those onto the yellowing raspberries. And one other thing that Mum bought was some wood ashes from her wood burning fire. They're very acidic as well, but I think we could use it around here. So I'll be using them sparingly, but I'm going to put some of those with the chicken pellets also onto the autumn fruit and raspberries that are looking a bit yellowy. I can't remember if I did show you the bean canes, but we've got those up now. And it's been really wet and windy and they've survived, so that's really good. But we are having lots of problems. I think it's mainly slugs and snails that are eating things. So this is the spinach that they've had a really good nibble on. They do seem to have left the next door row along. That's the rocket over there. We've been saving eggshells at home. So I've got this big tub of eggshells, which I am going to crunch up a bit more and put around that spinach and rocket just to try and protect it a little bit more from the slugs. These lettuces are doing great. But the tub next door, something has had a really good chomp on those, and there were some new seeds in there as well, and I haven't seen them come up. I think they've probably been eaten. But that's like a whole lettuce that's gone there. This lettuce, it was the same size as these. And I think the same thing has had a chomp on these spaghetti squashes. These ones I haven't put out yet. I have got three outside already, so I thought I would save these in here for spare for now. But they probably would fare better outside, I think. The sweet corn outside is doing well in the plastic bottles. I saved the bottom of those bottles, and I am going to make these into beer traps, but it's just too rainy to do that at the moment. All the beer would be far too diluted by the rain and just washed away, so there's no point in putting those out just yet. Some of the peas have had a really good munch on them as well, so this is where I'm going to place the beer traps. So far, it's just the sweet million of the tomato that's got some flowers coming on it. Once there are some more flowers on them, I'm going to be feeding these tomatoes with a coffee mixture, because tomatoes like it quite acidic. So I've been saving the coffee grinds at home, but they get diluted down quite a lot before it gets drenched onto the tomatoes. Going into the summer season, I do really want to use an organic fertiliser, and I'd like to make that myself. So I'm going to put today a mix of comfrey and nettles into if I don't get soaking wet from the rain, into a tub and just let that start to break down, and then I can dilute it when I'm doing my feeding in the greenhouse and around the plot over the summer. So there's lots of things available, I think, that I can use organically without, that are already available, you know, around the plot, using the comfrey, which has already taken the nutrients out of the soil, and adding them back in, and similarly with the nettles as well, and then coffee and eggshells from at home, the wood from Mum's fire, the chicken pellets are bought, but the horse manure, that's from the field next to Mum's house as well. So I really like that it's all local, it's all come from a very close radius to the plot, so there's lots of organic things that I can use without having to even buy anything. This chili had a really bad aphid problem, so I've wiped them off the leaves, just rubbing them between my thumb and finger, but I am going to wash it off with some warm soapy water, because there are still some in there. You don't know if you've got all the larvae or not. And I took it out of the greenhouse because I didn't want those to spread to the other plants that are in there. Now, normally I would leave it outside, but it's just been so cold and windy, I've shut it in the shed for now. I'm gonna give it a wash today and take it back into the greenhouse. I have been told that from tomorrow, the summertime is going to start and it's gonna be nice weather. So I'm sure I'll have more to show you next week. There's just not been a lot that I could have got done in all of the rain and wind this week. So I'll see you next week, guys. Bye.